Hello guys, and welcome back to another episode of StarCraft, where I take you through the missions, how to get the achievements. Today's mission is Sudden Strike, in the Covert Ops campaign. It's another Terran mission type. Alright, and the achievements are Sudden Strike, complete the mission. Arachnophot, destroy 30 enemies with the spider mines. Built to Last, prevent Admiral Horner's base from losing more than 5 structures on normal. This mission's actually pretty simple because it's still at the beginning of basically the Nova campaign, so it's kind of trying to introduce you into what, you know, she can do and what her troops are like. For the most part, what you'll be doing is basically on your barracks, you'll want to build a factory, the one that allows you to build 2 units at a time, and basically you'll just be building Reapers, because for the most part they're basically the best unit for this mission, and they're the one that the achievements rely heaviest on. And so what you're gonna do is basically the first attack wave is gonna come from the north side, which will be on the left, and all you have to do is mine down their paths with the spider mines, and then when they come down the path, they'll get blown up by the spider mines, and you can sit on the cliffs with your Reapers and with Nova and not have to worry about anything. And then once you get set up with that first, you know, the first attack that comes through, then you can just kind of simply mine each pathway, because there's 4 total pathways, and then about halfway down on each pathway they'll have a bisection. And basically what happens is on waves they'll come down one of those pathways, and then sometimes they can halfway down the pathway switch sides. So you'll definitely want to mine all the pathways. Like, see right here? This will be the first attack. And because you're using Reapers, they have that concussive grenades that they launch, so they deal minor, like, impact damage and stuff like that. So it's really effective when dealing with them. Also, throughout the map, you're going to find little Vespian geyser resources. So you'll want to grab those as soon as you can, because the Reapers do take 50 minerals and 50 gas apiece. As far as barracks go, bunkers, I really wouldn't worry about building any. If you think you'll need to, go ahead and fill that one bunker up, but for the most part, you're going to want to have a mobile force when dealing with this mission. And another thing is, try to keep your Reapers up on these cliffs, because you really don't want them to be down there, because Reapers don't have that much life, so they're really easy to be killed. But if you can keep them out of range of stuff, like up on cliffs, then they are very tactically sound, because they won't, you know, they won't be able to take damage from Zerglings or roaches or anything like that. So just like I did there, just kind of stay to the cliffs, and then once the attacks are done, go ahead and lay spider mines. Try to keep them evenly spaced throughout all 4 paths, and just go back and forth after a attack wave comes through. Go ahead and re-mine that area, because the spider mines are basically invaluable at that point. And the other thing is, as soon as you have the ability to fill out your barracks with Reapers, keep them coming as often as possible, because basically they're going to be the best unit for you right now. Because of the terrain on this map, it's all hilly and, you know, divided and stuff like that, so Marines would have to go all the way around to get to any point on this map. Now the other thing is, don't Nova doesn't have any medics. So if your units start taking a lot of damage, what you're going to need to do is bring them back to Horner's base where he has all the medics and have them get healed up. So if they start looking like they're, you know, kind of in bad shape, send them back to Admiral Horner and he'll take care of them. Now I believe at about the 10 or 15 minute mark, they'll start attacking from both sides. And at that point, what you're going to want to do is basically you're going to split your force evenly down the middle and send one half on one side and the other half on the other. And a good tactic to use as far as equipment with Nova is you'll get the Reaper suit for this mission regardless, but you'll want to take either the concussive grenade, which does the big area of effect damage, and her shotgun blast. Because a lot of the units, these Zerg units that'll be coming through here, will be light units, like Zerglings and Banelings and stuff like that, and the shotgun blast can take them out in about one hit. And aside from that, this mission's really just kind of a cakewalk. Stay up on the ledges and just kind of let them come to you. And if at all possible, a good tactic to use is to hit them from both sides at once. So basically like I'm doing here, having a group up on one side of the wall and a group up on the other ledge is a good way to do what's like a pincer attack when it comes to these Zerg rushes. And just like I was doing there, after the attack wave came through, go ahead and reset those mines. Always, always, always replace your mines after an attack wave. Now, on this part, they're going to have you go try to rescue some tech. It's not necessary to defeat the level or get the achievements, but kind of like Solarite and Kerrigan levels and stuff like that, they are upgrades for your units and Nova. So basically what you're going to want to do is if you want to upgrade Nova, you're going to have to go get these techs, which this would be probably one of the only times I'd suggest actually going to pick up the techs for the missions, the bonus, you know, the bonus side objectives, because basically they all provide bonuses not just to Nova, but they provide bonuses to your troops as well. In one of the later missions, your tanks get the ability to basically do a jump jet, which is basically the same way that a Reaper does his thing, where it jumps over a cliff, but it's a tank that can do it. So it's one of those that's like, that's a really, really useful tool. And also, I believe they get replenishing steel, which is basically, if you equip it on your mechanical units, they automatically will replace they automatically heal their armor and life, so those are really good. That's why I was saying, this is probably the only time where I'd say getting the bonus objectives or the levels would be a good idea, because it's not necessary for the mission, but in order to have a toolkit for your characters, I would definitely get it. Yeah, see, at this point, they were starting to go, you know, cross over the path, because they started on the second path, and then they were going to go over to the first path. And they'll do that from time to time. They'll come down one path, and then halfway down, they'll switch to the other path. So that's just one thing you have to be aware of. And another good rule of thumb is after every attack, go ahead and draw your forces back, the ones that aren't laying mines, and have them get healed up at Horner's base. Here comes the next attack. It's going to be on the right side, looks like. again, just put them up on the cliffs and let them take out whatever makes it this far. You don't want to set up too close to the entrance of these paths, because you actually want stuff to die to the spider mines. So about halfway through, you want basically just to let them run down the spider mines and then have them get killed by them. Looks like we got this mission in the bag, so we ain't got to worry much about it. I believe here pretty soon that the other tech, the bonus tech part of the mission will pop up down at the bottom right. And that one's a little bit harder to get than that top one was, because that top one, I was basically done with it before I was done with the description of it. But the bottom one has a little bit more resistance on it, so just be aware of that when you're going to take it out. Oh yeah, and about halfway through this mission, they start putting up zerglings and stuff on the cliffs to try to ambush you. So after each attack wave, go ahead and go back over the cliffs, so this way that you can catch the ambushes before they get to you. And you see how I'm spread out on all three cliffs here. Basically, that I want to make sure that I catch this next attack with a pincer attack. So whichever way they go down, I can just move troops in, like I moved them in from the opposite wall, which I was supposed to do it the opposite way, which is move these in from this wall up to the middle. So this way they're all attacking this group that's coming in from both sides. And you really should avoid bringing your Reapers down onto the ground, because, like I said, they're vulnerable and they don't have a lot of life. Here comes the next attack. Go ahead and set up on the cliffs over here. Yeah, as you can see, they've got a bunch of zerglings that they're putting up on these cliffs to try to prevent me from ambushing them. But there's not too many of them, so it's not too much of a worry. The scorpion zergs are mean, because they don't cloak the units, but they make it to where ranged units can't target them, so. Alright, here comes the next bonus thing coming up. And always, always, always put down supply depots, so this way you're not capped, like I always, always, always am. You don't really have to clean out all the Zerg, but each attack wave puts a new group of Zerg up there. So it's just good rule of thumb to clear them out. So this way, you're not, when an attack wave comes, you're not trying to clear them out and take on an attack wave. Yeah, as you can see, it had a couple of Ravagers down there. It's still nothing to be worried at, but just be aware that when you send a force down there, don't send something too small that can't handle it. The only disappointing thing is you can't equip the things mid-battle or change your equipment, because that would be kind of cool to switch, you know, Nova from being the jump jet Nova to the stealth Nova mid-mission, but I guess that would be kind of a little bit broken for her. Oh yeah, I just saw the new release, the new trailer for the Alaric co-op commander. He looks like so much fun. I cannot wait to play him. And I think it's awesome that we're going to get him both in the co-op missions. I mean, we're going to get him in StarCraft as a co-op commander, but we're also getting him in Heroes of the Storm as a playable character. And I was like, yes! Here I'm trying to divide my forces so they can take both attacks. This is where I was saying that the macro will come in handy, because you're going to need to be able to basically be on both sides of the map at once with your army. And it's not impossible, but it is kind of difficult. So it's one of those things you do have to be sure to keep track of. And then once, if you've cleaned up one side, go ahead and bring the line of troops over, so this way they can help clean up the other side. Alright, let's replace these spider mines real quick. Do the same thing. I really wish the Reaper was a little bit more tough of a unit and didn't cost as much Vespian. Like, I would be stoked if it like had like 20 more health, costed 25 Vespian, and basically that was it. I mean, I wouldn't even care if it required the tech lab at that point. It's just one of those things, like, that would make that unit so much better in my opinion, because it has that versatility of movement, you know, the jumping around and stuff like that. Plus it has the concussive grenades, which deal not quite an AoE, but they deal a heavy damage. So it makes them really good as a unit. And then it's just one of those things, I wish a little bit of tweaking to certain units would make them a lot better in my opinion. Now they're sending Ultralisks. They'll get through, right? Not on your life. Now see what I'm doing here is I'm kind of putting Reapers down to basically bait them and make them kind of stay put for a minute, because with Ultralisks they have a higher life pool, so I need to beat on them for a little bit longer, and the easiest way to do that is to basically bait them back up the path, and then basically after they've run through a bunch of mines, go ahead and, you know, pull them back for a minute or two. Also, don't forget to check, like, the ends of these pathways, because the Zerg will occasionally send queens and stuff like that to basically spread creep down the pathways, which makes the Zerg units travel faster. And that's one thing you really don't want to happen, because the faster the Zerg are, the more likely they'll get back to Horner, and more likely, you know, he'll lose buildings before you can clean up his stuff. Ooh, they're sending a Brutalisk. Just one, not so much of a problem. This must be Abathur's work. What I want to know is, now that we've seen that the Protoss, well, the Tal'Darim at least, are involved, but on our side, I want to know what the Zerg are doing, like the actual Zerg, not the ones being controlled and forced here. I want to know what Zagara is doing at this point in time, because she is right now in charge of the Swarm, because Kerrigan left on her Zelnaga godhood trip, and she took Raynor with him. So basically, the leaders of the Terrans right now are Admiral Horner and Valerian, Emperor Valerian. Those are the leaders of the Terrans. As far as the Protoss are concerned, I believe that they've got two factions right now, which the first is the Templar faction, which is basically, you got Karrax, you got Volsrune, you have Artanis, and I believe that's, oh, and you have the Cyber Protoss, which are part of that group, and they're led by the reincarnated Phoenix. I can't remember what his name is, but those are all in one group. And then on the other hand of that, you have the Tal'Darim, which are a more militaristic, basically almost psychotic version of the Protoss, where Protoss are all about having a fair fight and, you know, basically honor and rules and all this different stuff like that. The Tal'Darim are very much, you know, victory by any means, if it means I can take you out by, you know, rigging something up, or, you know, hiring another force to take you out. That's very much the Tal'Darim's MO. So it's quite interesting to see that the first race that we've run into in this campaign is the Tal'Darim. So, and again, I'm just wondering, what is Zagara thinking about the Defenders of Man basically using her troops? I mean, I don't think she'd care that they're killing Terrans, but I think she'd be ticked off at the fact that the Terrans would have the gall to try to control the Swarm, and that's what would get her moving. So again, I just want to see what they're going to do about that. Yeah, I lose one building in this mission, I think, and I think that's the only one I lose. Keep off the ground. Whoops. That dude died. Like, bad. No, you can't lose that. Things get a little bit hairy at the end, but that's just because they just keep this unrelenting force pushing. But as you can see, I got the mission done and got the achievements. So if y'all like what y'all saw, give me a like and a share and a comment down below. If y'all don't, I'll appreciate a negative comment just as well. I'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks for watching.